The recent rise in inflation, driven mainly by oil and agricultural product prices, has given rise to concerns that the living conditions of low-income households are worsening. Accordingly, this study analyzes the changes and discrepancies in the real purchasing power of different income quintiles and draws on the implications to examine the increasing burden of low-income households. Real purchasing power is the purchasing power as determined by real income, and therefore can be ascertained through real income, which reflects both the CPI and nominal income. So let's look into the CPI and changes in the nominal income from 2003 to 2016. A comparison of the yearly average CPI inflation rate by income quintile reveals that there was little change during the 13-year period. With total households averaging 2.2%, the lowest of first income quintile 2.26%, and the highest of fifth income quintile 2.22%. On the other hand, the nominal income revealed a gap between the quintiles, with the first averaging a yearly growth of 3.5% and the fifth 4.2%. Such a gap in income has been long sustained since the 2008 financial crisis, when the growth rate of the first quintile's average yearly nominal income was just half of the fifth quintile's. Next, on an examination of the real income, which reflects the CPI and nominal income, we can observe that while the real monthly income for the first quintile increased an average of just 200,000 won from 1.23 million to 1.43 million, that of the fifth increased a staggering 1.79 million won, hitting 8.25 million from 6.46 million. Based on the comparison results, it can be estimated that the gap in the real purchasing power between the first and fifth quintiles increased by more than 10% during the past 13 years, mainly driven by the growth rate in nominal income than inflation. Then, how has the gap in the real purchasing power changed household income? If we review the type of household income by quintile, we can see that the real earned income for the first quintile has stalled since 2003, while that of the fifth quintile has consistently risen. It should be noted, however, that the real purchasing power gap has not widened as the transfer income of the former has increased rapidly since the financial crisis. The main force driving the sluggish growth in the first quintile's earned income is the increase in the share of households aged 60 and over, whose earned income has decreased upon retirement.
저소득층과 고소득층 간 실질 구매력 격차는 주로 금융위기 이전의 명목 소득 증가율 차이에 기인하며 소비자 물가는 소득 수준과 상관없이 매우 유사한 상승세를 유지한 것으로 나타났습니다. 이러한 결과는 가계 소비 여력과 실질 소득 불균형을 완화하기 위해 저소득층 중심의 소득 개선 정책이 핵심임을 시사합니다. 소비자의 구입 빈도가 높은 필수재의 가격 안정을 위해 공급 물량을 확보하는 정책은 불가피한 측면이 있습니다. 그러나 체감 물가 상승을 근거로 일부 품목의 가격을 인위적으로 통제하는 정책은 오히려 경제 전체의 자원 배분을 왜곡할 수 있으므로 지양하는 것이 바람직합니다. 또한 고령층 비중이 높은 저소득층을 중심으로 소득 여건을 개선하여 소득 분위별 구매력 편차를 완화할 필요가 있습니다.